times during the routine health checkup, people will find that their blood glucose levels are coming borderline, which are not actually fitting into the diagnosis of diabetes. So they are actually suffering from a condition called pre-diabetes. And pre-diabetes is a condition which has very high chances of progression to diabetes if it's not recognized and treated on time. So how one can prevent this progression of pre-diabetes to diabetes? The only intervention which has proven till now and is very effective in prevention to prevent this progression from pre-diabetes to diabetes is a lifestyle modification, which means that if a person can take care of his or her weight, then he or she can actually prevent the development of diabetes for a long, long time. So keeping the weight in control is very important. Even if a person can lose 5 to 7% of his or her original body weight, there is a chance that you can reduce the progression of this pre-diabetes diabetes by almost 60%. So how to keep your weight in check? It's by eating a healthy diet. So a consult with a nutritionist is also a good idea, because they can carefully plan your diet in terms of carbohydrate intake, protein and the fat intake. So it's, you need to cut down on your carbohydrates in your diet, so it's better if you get a nutritionist plan. And secondly, the very important part is the exercise. The combination of diet and exercise both are important. Exercise in the form of aerobic exercise, cardio, which can be in the form of a brisk walking, running or a jogging around 30 to 40 minutes daily. And if combined with strengthening exercises twice or thrice a week, will help more in losing weight as well as maintaining the blood glucose levels. Suffering from diabetes. Now, how do we ensure that we are having a good blood glucose control? So one of the measures which test the blood glucose control is HbA1c or glycosylated hemoglobin levels. This is a simple blood test in which the value will tell you what is your average blood glucose over the last 3 months. So what are the target values? We target the values depending upon the age of the person. Most of the guidelines and the recommendation says that if the person is young, that is a person is having his age is below 60 years, then we can target an HbA1c value of less than 7%. However, in elderly patients above 60 to 70 years, risk of hypoglycemia, low blood glucose increases. So in those cases, we can target HbA1c somewhere between 7 to 8%. This is applicable to most of the patients with diabetes. However, there are certain subset of diabetes patients who are suffering from comorbid conditions. That means either they are having a kidney disease or a heart disease or a liver disease. In these cases also, we should not be aiming a very strict blood glucose control, because these are the patients who are prone for hypoglycemia. So in these cases also, we can target an HbA1c value of somewhere between 7 to 8%. Suffering from either type 1 or type 2 diabetes needs to be careful in recognizing the complications and needs to know how to prevent these complications. So there are many three steps to prevent these complications. Number one is, and very foremost important, is the lifestyle modification. Second is to take care of taking the medications in a regular way. And the third is going for regular checkups to your doctor. Now the regular checkups are very important, because many a times when the patients feel that they're not feeling any, having any symptoms, that means they're fine. that may not be the truth actually. So regular checkups will always identify the complications at the right stage so that we can prevent the progression of these complications. Diabetes mellitus or GDM is defined as development of diabetes in a woman during pregnancy. That is, the woman who is pregnant, she detects for the first time that she is having a high blood sugar level. This is called gestational diabetes. There are certain risk factors for developing gestational. Not all women are at risk. The women who are more at risk are the ones who have a family history for diabetes, who are obese, or who are suffering from already blood, high blood pressure or high cholesterol levels, or who have a sedentary lifestyle. These are the women who are more prone to develop gestational diabetes mellitus. How to detect this condition? This is detected by doing a blood test called OGTT, oral glucose tolerance test, which is done at the time of 24 to 28 weeks of pregnancy, in which 75 grams of glucose is given. And that glucose is checked at the fasting and the 1 hour and 2 hour diet. Throughout time, and depending upon the blood glucose readings, this is how the gestational diabetes is diagnosed and how to treat it. The gestational diabetes is not a very severe form of diabetes, it's a milder one. Most of the cases are managed well with only the dietary changes. However, few women might require addition of insulin, and insulin is always the best and the safest treatment for the treatment of gestational diabetes mellitus. Another implication of GDM is that in the long run, these women should be careful that they need to keep on checking their blood sugar once in a year or once in 3 years, because there is high risk of developing type 2 diabetes in these women. Hypoglycemia means low blood sugar. Low blood sugar means when your blood sugar levels drops below 70 milligram per deciliter, then you call it hypoglycemia. It is very important to recognize what hypoglycemia means. What do you feel when you have hypoglycemia? So when a person experiences hypoglycemia, low blood sugar, he or she can have trembling of hands, sweating, little palpitations. The person can feel very weak at that point of time. He will feel very hungry, and also the person can feel a little dizzy, and sometimes it's just a headache and a little blurring out of vision, which can also happen. And in severe cases, when the blood sugar drops below 50, a person can actually lose consciousness and can fall while sitting or walking. So it's very important to recognize these symptoms, and when it happens, if you are at home, the best thing is first to check your blood sugar with your glucometer to confirm it that this is because of the low blood sugar. So your glucometer reading is showing below 70, or if the person is elderly and even can happen below 80 also, at that point of time you should consider it to be a hypoglycemia. So how to treat it? The treatment is very simple, but it has to be very quick. Treatment comprises of taking 15 gram of carbohydrates in the form of 3 teaspoons of sugar, or 3 teaspoons of Glucon-D powder, which can dissolve very easily, or 3 teaspoons of honey will also do, or a half a cup of soft drink. It should not be a diet soft drink. By consuming this, blood sugar should be checked again after 15 minutes, and we call it a rule of 15. And after 15 minutes, you have to check the blood sugar again. If it has not touched 100, you need to repeat that 15 gram of carbohydrate once again. And again, you check it after 15 minutes till the time you reach a value of 100. once you reach a value of 100, then a person should also consume something to eat. If it's a meal time, have your meal. If it is not a meal time, consume some good healthy snack so that it is hypoglycemia does not trigger again. And to prevent the hypoglycemia, the tips are: consume your meals on time, do not delay your meals, take your medicines on time, and if there is a physical overexertion, then you make sure that your diet is compensating that kind of physical.